During a Trump campaign rally at Madison Square Garden on November 27th of 2024, comedian Tony Hinchcliffe made a joke about Puerto Rico, referring to it as a floating island of garbage. The so-called joke sparked widespread criticism and condemnation for its offensive and insensitive nature, while at the same time many others felt that it was just a joke and that Puerto Ricans and others who were offended need to stop being Karens and have a sense of humor. What many don't know is that Puerto Ricans have seen this type of language before throughout their history, and it was also covered up as a joke. Tony Hinchcliffe is an American stand-up comedian and writer who gained prominence through his work on the podcast Kill Tony. Hinchcliffe's comedy style includes observational humor and roast, and he often blurs the line between edgy and controversial. His comedy often draws attention for his provocative nature, which can lead to both enthusiastic fans and significant criticism. For those that know and support Hinchcliffe, his stint at the Trump rally was no surprise. They argue he's a raunchy comedian and he spares no one. His joke about Puerto Rico being a floating island of garbage was just that, a joke. So get over it. Some Puerto Ricans who weren't offended by the so-called joke say that many didn't understand the context. They argue that Hinchcliffe wasn't referring to Puerto Ricans as garbage, but that he was making a joke about Puerto Rico's waste problem. And guess what? Puerto Rico does have a waste problem. So does the U.S., but in Puerto Rico, it's even worse. The island struggles with limited landfill space, frequent illegal dumping, and an inadequate recycling infrastructure. Over the years, the primary landfill, Toa Baja, has reached capacity, leading to environmental concerns and health risks. So I guess in this context, the joke does have some meaning. However, it was still a bad joke, especially for those who see this context more as a smokescreen than an actual explanation. Those that were offended and don't buy the "it was just a joke" argument can point to history. Probably the most famous instance when someone's words about Puerto Rico or Puerto Ricans was demeaning was the Cornelius Rhodes letter. Cornelius Rhodes was an American physician and researcher who was conducting research at a hospital in San Juan, Puerto Rico in the 1930s. On November 10th of 1931, Rhodes was at a party at a Puerto Rican co-worker's house in Sidra. After having some drinks, he left and found that his car had been vandalized. He went to his office where he wrote and signed a letter addressed to a colleague. In the letter, Rhodes made highly offensive comments about the people of Puerto Rico, expressing a belief that they were racially inferior and suggesting he would conduct experiments on them without consent. Speaking about Puerto Ricans, he wrote, "They are beyond the dirtiest, laziest, most degenerate, and thievish race of men ever inhabiting this sphere. It makes you sick to inhabit the same island with them. What the island needs is not public health work, but a tidal wave or something to totally exterminate the population. It might then be livable." He even went as far as confessing a crime. "I have done my best to further the process of extermination by killing off 8 and transplanting cancer into several more." Rhodes' unmailed letter was found by one of his staff members, and shortly after it was spread by the nationalists around the island. For his part, Dr. Cornelius Rhodes responded by saying the contents of the letter were just a joke to his friend and nothing more. Given this kind of history, it's not surprising that many Puerto Ricans would be upset about Tony Hinchcliffe's joke at the Trump rally. After all, they heard the "it's just a joke" line before. Now, I'm not saying that Hinchcliffe is the equivalent of a Cornelius Rhodes. In fact, Hinchcliffe is an actual comedian, as opposed to Rhodes, who was a doctor. And to be honest, I don't think Hinchcliffe had any ill will towards Puerto Rico or its people. I just think he told a bad joke in a political setting without thinking it through. But I could be wrong. Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Help us to spread this video by sharing. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell for more videos.